verses out of John the 21st chapter. Glory to God. We're going to skip around a little bit this morning. For truly God is good, glory to God. And we as a people need to realize how good God is in our lives, glory to God. And once you realize how good God is in your life, you won't want to do nothing else. You won't want to break any of his commandments. You wouldn't want to sin against him, glory to God. But you will want to live according to his will and his way, glory to God. We're coming from John, the 21st chapter this morning. And we're gonna start with the 15th verse through the 17th verse on this morning, glory to God. And then we're going to jump over into 1 Corinthians, the 13th chapter, glory to God. And we're going to go from there, glory to God, however the Holy Spirit leads us this morning, glory to God. But your topic in your hearing this morning is love conquers all, glory to God. And I just want to talk about love this morning because Jesus Christ is love, glory to God. And everything he did for us, he did out of love, glory to God. We owe him everything. We owe him our life. We owe him our dedication to him, glory to God. We owe him to be loyal to him, glory to God. One thing I do know about love, glory to God, love conquers all, glory to God. Love forgives, glory to God. Love, glory to God, receive you even when you don't look like somebody that's worth receiving, glory to God. And we know that's no such thing, but love forgives, glory to God. Love honors, glory to God. Love corrects, glory to God. It brings chastisement, glory to God. Even though many seem like it ain't love because you being chastised for this or you being chastised for that. Well, this is what love does. Love brings correction, glory to God. Love is stable, glory to God. Love never wavers, glory to God. It's stable, glory to God. One thing about true love, you stand on it, it is firm, glory to God. You don't have to worry about this going on or that going on, glory to God. And the greatest example of all that pertains to love is Jesus Christ, glory to God. He loved us so that he gave his very own life for us, glory to God. He didn't have to come down here and wrap himself in flesh. He didn't have to do this for us. But because he loved us, glory to God, he did this. See, what's going on today, Sister Shamika? It's no more love in the world no more. Everybody's spewing out hate, glory to God. They're spewing out that deadly venom trying to kill this person, kill that person. Well, guess what? Today, we're going to kill hate today, glory to God, because we're going to come right here. Love conquers all, glory to God. Amen. And we're going to tell it, look, if you don't have love in your heart, you are not a child of God. Because God's children should have love.
Amen. Thank you.
Glory to God. We got to have love. The word of God said, how can you say that you love me, glory to God, when you see your sister and your brothers every day on a day-to-day basis and you can't even look and help them? You can't even acknowledge them for being a child of God. You can't even extend your hand in their time of need. So how can you say that you love me?
Amen.
Glory to God. Glory to God. Because one thing about love, like I said, love conquers all. Love has feelings. Love hurt, glory to God. See, no doubt, glory to God, Jesus could have walked away from the cross, but he went up there anyway, glory to God. When they nailed him, that wasn't just no nail, glory to God, that just stamped right there in his hand. That was a nail that went through his flesh. Amen. Glory to God. Love can stand, withstand pain, glory to God. Because love would do right, glory to God. Amen. You know, Al Green, I think it was, used to have a song called Love and Happiness, glory to God. And in this song, he'll say, well, love will make you do right. Well, and he had another part, but I'm going to rewrite that part for you today. He said, love will make you do wrong, but no, love will not. Love will make you do what is right, glory to God. Amen. Love will make you stand up, glory to God. When you know you need to stand up and do what is right by God. Love will make you, glory to God, turn away from things that try to destroy you and keep you from God.
Yeah.
Glory to God.
Amen.
John 20, the 21st chapter, starting at the 15th verse, glory to God. And God is just truly good. I love my Lord because this is the time when Jesus is getting ready to ascend on high, glory to God. And he's having the last meal, glory to God, with the disciples. You can read it, glory to God, on your own time. I'm just giving you a little bits of information. And this is the time, glory to God, he chose to talk to Peter, glory to God. And today, glory to God, Jesus is still talking, glory to God. Today he's letting us know, glory to God. If you will, glory to me, the 15th verse says, so when they had when they had dined, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of Jonah, lovest thou me more than these? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest that I love thee. He said unto him, feed my lambs. He said unto him again the second time, Simon, son of Jonah, lovest thou me? He said unto him, yea, Lord, thou knowest I love thee. He said unto him, feed my sheep. Verse 17 said, he said unto him the third time, Simon, son of Jonah, lovest thou me? Peter was grieved because he said unto him the third time, lovest thou me? And he said unto him, Lord, thou knowest all things. Thou knowest that I love thee. Jesus said unto him, feed my sheep. Amen. See, love gives you what you need.
Amen.
You don't have to be in want when it comes down to love.
Amen.
Love takes care of you, glory to God.
Amen.
When I'm sick in my body, love will come in, glory to God. Because that love that Jesus has for me,
Amen.
It will come in and touch my body.
Amen.
Because I know that Jesus Christ, when he went to the cross, he laid out his life. He said, I was wounded. I took the nails in my hand, the nails in my feet. I took the piercing in my side for you to be healed today,
Amen.
Glory to God. He said, I was wounded for your transgressions and bruised for your iniquities.
Amen.
And the chastisement of my peace is Amen. Upon you. So feed my sheep, glory to God.
Amen.
Let them know that I love them. Let them know that I have everything there is that they need, glory
Amen.
To God. They don't have to turn to these false gods.
Amen.
You don't have to serve that false god.
Amen.
You don't have to go in wishing and believing. But you will know, glory to God, that you have a God that loves you in spite of.
Amen.
You will know that he will provide. He said over in Philippians, I shall provide all of your needs according to his riches and his glory, which be in him, Christ Jesus.
Amen.
You don't have to want for nothing. Because he said, look, baby, I love you. I love you.
Praise
the Lord. And one thing we can say, glory to God, that Jesus Christ's love is unconditional.
Amen.
It's true. It's real.
Amen.
Glory to God. It does not provoke. It does not, Sister Mika, make you feel uncomfortable.
Amen.
It does not, glory to God, take away from you the things that you need.
Amen.
Love, glory to God. Oh, God, oh, that gracious love. It provides, glory to God.
Amen.
Jesus talking to Peter, he said, do you love me? Because if we love him enough, glory to God, we'll feed his sheep.
Amen.
Feeding sheep don't mean going out there throwing no corn at him. No, when you're feeding God's sheep, you got to look, baby. I understand that you like him, but he's not the one, glory to God. Hold on, glory to God. God will send the one he have for you to make you a wife, glory to God, that you may be, he may be an awesome husband for you. Or you wait, baby. God will send you the one for you to make you a husband that you may not have to want for nothing. Because, see, Jesus is a provider. He's a provider. And one thing about it, because he loved us, he proved it. He said, look, I love you enough to take all this mess that you have given unto me. He didn't deserve it. We still persecuting him today. We still driving nails in his hand. Still driving nails in his feet. Still piercing him in his side.
Amen.
He don't deserve it, glory to God. But he said, I love you.
Yes,
he said, I love you. I woke you up this morning so you'll have another chance
Amen.
To get it right before me.
Amen.
I love you enough, Sister Latrice. You don't have to worry about who's going to come and do for you. I'm going to provide for you.
Amen.
I got everything you need. Only thing you have to do is just trust me. Trust me. We're talking about love this morning. It conquers all, glory to God. Love ain't gonna leave you out there stranded and nowhere to go, nothing to eat, nothing. No, love gonna provide everything you need.
Amen.
You hungry? Jesus said, look, I am the bread of life.
Amen.
You in doubt? You don't know what to do? He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life.
Amen.
This is what he said. Because it's love. You want to know how to be blessed? He said, honor thy mother and thy father. Do good in the land of the living. He said, look, turn away from those things that are not all, that beguiles you, keeps you from coming in and doing what is right by God. If you love me, glory to God, you will feed my sheep. You will teach them what they need to know. You will let them know, glory to God, that this is what I'm for and this is what not what I'm for. I'm all about love. I'm all about peace. I'm all about joy. I'm all about tempers and long suffering. But I cannot, I will not, glory to God, honor sin.
Amen.
He will not honor adultery.
Amen.
He will not honor fornication. He will not honor lying against your neighbor. He will not honor, glory to God, a backbiting, glory to God. He will not honor homosexuality. I'm sorry, he will not honor any of this. He will not. He won't have anything to do with that stuff, Sister Shamika. But we got pastors preaching that it's okay. God know who you. God know what you. He made you like you is. No, he created us, but we had our own free will to come and make our own choices as to what we do in our lives. The devil is a liar. We will not wear that one. Talking about he created you like he is, so you can walk and behave like a. When you a woman, behave like a man. He did not create us like this. Our God is not confused.
Amen.
And he's not the author of confusion. He's a God of love. And he said, look, even in that right there, I look past that because I love you. He only wants your soul to be saved.
Amen.
He only wants you to be delivered.
Thank you.
That's all he wants.
Yes.
He don't want all this other crazy stuff that everybody putting out there that he so wants. He even told us obedience is better than sacrifice. He desire our obedience, glory to God. Later for everything else and anybody else, let's be obedient unto God. He loved us enough all the way up to the cross and then past the cross. He's sitting up there now on the right hand side of the Father, still loving us, interceding on behalf of us.
Amen.
So guess what? You're not alone. Love said, I'll be with you wherever you go.
Amen.
He said, if you make your bed in hell, I'm going to be right there with you. Because I love you. But when you end up in hell, that's your choice. It's not mine.
Amen.
Love conquers all.
Yes, it does.
See, when I'm sick, love lets me know that I'm going to be well. I don't have to give up. See, Deacon, when it seems like things are going hard for me, love will let me know simply just stand.
Amen.
I don't have to follow in these evil, wicked ways. I don't have to follow in that direction. All I got to do is stand and see the salvation of the Lord.
Amen.
Glory to God.
Thank you.
Go with me to the 1 Corinthians chapter 13, glory to God, starting at the first verse. See, love, glory to God, it shows.
It
really shows. When a person say they love you, glory to God, that means you can greet me in spite of how I look.
You can
be around me in spite of the things that I have, the clothes I wear, glory to God, or the smell that's on my body. You won't turn me away when you know that I'm in need. This is what love does. You provide, glory to God. You will help. He loves us, glory to God. He loves us more than we even love ourselves. We walk around here talking about, oh, I love him. Oh, he's my, he be, oh, I'm so in love. No, honey, you ain't in love. This, it's a difference between lust and infatuation. Love is what Jesus did. Love is what Jesus put in us as Christians where we're supposed to be walking upright.
Amen.
I love my neighbor like I love myself.
Yeah.
Meaning I'm not going to hurt my neighbor if I'm not going to hurt myself.
Amen.
I'm not going to walk out on my neighbor because I don't want nobody to walk out on me. And I'm not going to walk out on myself.
Amen. Praise
love is a provider, Deacon.
Yeah,
see, God is where we got our DNA from.
Amen.
And if his love is in us, guess what? I can speak to you regardless of what you did to me. I can pray for you regardless to how you feel about me. Because I got the love of God in me.
Yeah.
And this is what we need now. The world now lacks love. We need to show love, glory to God, everywhere we go, glory to God. We need to let people know God loves you. I love you.
Amen.
You're my sister. You're my brother.
Praise the Lord.
Glory to God. I love you. 1 Corinthians chapter 13, verse 1 said, though I speak with the tongues of men and of angels and have not charity, I am become as sounding brass or a tinkling cymbal. And though I have the gift of prophecy, and I understand all mysteries and all knowledge, and though I have all faith so that I could remove mountains, and have not charity, I am nothing. Love conquers all. Amen. That's what charity is, love. And see, Paul broke it down. He said, though I can speak with enticing words and make you feel good, guess what? If I don't have no love in my heart, I ain't did nothing. It don't profit me nothing and you nothing either. Because all I did was made it hard for both of us. When all we got to do is open up and do what is right. Paul said, look, though I have the gift of prophecy, many uses their gift, glory to God. Want to prophesy, speak this in somebody's life, speak that in somebody's life, but don't have no love in their heart. If you don't have love in your heart, guess what? That prophecy is non and void. Because guess what? Jesus got what he, Jesus, if you don't have that love, you can't speak something in somebody's life.
Amen.
What do you think jealousy and hatred and all that come from? The evilness that's within our hearts. See, our hearts tell a lot about us. It tells a lot, Shamika. When we go out those doors and we walking around, people look at us, how you act. That's why they tell how you really are. Is that a woman of God? Is that a man of God? If you walking around here with your head up in the air, you too good to speak to your sister, or you too good to do for your brothers, just cause he out there and he all, how you want to say that, violated with alcohol all over him, and she all out there, all strung out on drugs, and you feel like you too good to go and give them a, put your arm around them and hug them, guess what? There is no love there.
Amen. Praise the Lord.
Cause them the main ones Jesus Christ looks at. Yeah. Them are your sisters and your brothers. Yeah. Them the ones you need to go out there and love, glory to God. We got so much hatred going on around here. Instead of us helping people, we out here destroying them. Come on in the church. Come on in. God will bless you with this. Take our eyes off the materialistic stuff and place our eyes on the heart of man. Amen. So that we can help these people get delivered. Amen. God wants his people to be delivered, glory to God. I was sitting up last night and I couldn't take my eyes off of it. Watching, glory to God, Left Behind, glory to God, parts 1, 2, and 3 that they were showing on TV. And as I looked at all this stuff, I'm like, God, this is really, people don't have a clue that this is what's going on today. The enemy is setting each and every one of us up for a downfall. Because you're not going to get past, if you're doing his will, you're not going to make it to heaven.
Praise the Lord.
If you can't help your brother, your sister, your fellow man, you're not going to make it to heaven.
Amen.
And as I was watching those movies last night, I'm saying, God, this is what's happening, glory to God. Everything is being set up, glory to God. I remember Pastor preached a message called That Great Fall of Babylon. It's happening.
Amen.
It's happening. You can't tell me that you sit up there and you love me, but you slapping me upside my head. You taking everything from me. Every time I go get something, you taking it. You can't tell me you love me.
Amen.
Love don't mistreat you. Love, when love is on board, guess what? I do whatever it is I can do for you. Oh, you want to shut off my back? You can have it.
Amen.
Oh, you need a place to live? Come on. You come over here and live. I'll provide for you. See, this is what love is, a provider. Jesus is a provider. This is what he did for us, glory to God. This is what he did for all of us around here. I don't know why we sit up here and feel like that we got to point the finger at this person and that person when all of us is at fault when we're not showing love, when we're not doing what God tells us to do, when we see our sisters and brothers out there and they in need and we started walking past them going, I'm guilty, y'all. I done drove past two of them just this week, glory to God. You see them out there in need and you don't even stop to help them. You know your sister can't come out of that there prostitution because she needs somebody to help her. You know she's not strong enough to come out of it by herself. But you start, that don't make no sense. Every time I drive past it, she out here on this corner. Well, if you keep coming past it, then obviously God wants you to stop. Speak a word of encouragement in her life. Let her know that God loves her. She can come out of that there mess, that God can provide for her better than she can provide for herself.
Amen.
But we call ourselves Christians. Call ourselves Christians and don't have an ounce of love in us. We worse than the ones that have not even come in to repent yet.
Amen.
When Jesus speaking in this word of God, he's speaking to us.
Yes, he is.
His church. Because this is what's going on in his church today. Mm-hmm. We don't have time, Sister Shamika, to go out here and help nobody. No, what I'm going to get. We're so selfish, so cold-hearted. This is not love. This is not what God intended to be in the body of Christ. And then we want to sit around and talk, it don't make no sense. Ain't hiding nobody showing up at church. Well, what are you doing? Are you showing love? Are you embracing them when they come into church? Or are you quickly putting your mouth on them, running them out of the church? Which one? Only time Jesus Christ comes in and corrects us is when we're wrong. He tells us he loved those that he chastises. So if we're doing wrong, he gonna bring out that rod of correction. That just like a parent, if that child is doing wrong, you gonna bring out that rod of correction. Say, look, baby, you're doing what, I don't like what you're doing. Don't do that right there. That's not good for you. How many parents, as the word of God say, what father would know that his child is hungry and give him a stone to feed him? How many parents out there know that their child is doing things wrong, but sit there and tell them and welcome them in and let them do it anyway? If you're doing that, something wrong with you. Because we're put here, the word of God said, train up a child in the way that they should go. Even though they may depart, guess what? That word will still be in them and they will still come back to the Lord. But no, not today, Deacon. I don't have time to discipline my daughter. So Shamika, I'm not going to discipline my daughter. Today, me and my daughter is going to be friends. We're going to be friends. And whatever she do, I keep on Latrice. Oh, you so precious. Mm-hmm. Huh. And God sitting there saying, I'm going to show you how precious she is when I lay sickness on her. Because you're supposed to be teaching them. See, all these kids that's laying up in these hospitals and stuff that are sick, that's a generational curse. That comes from somewhere, from the parents, grandparents, somebody being disobedient. Mm-hmm. We don't want to chastise our children no more. Oh, don't you whip little Timmy. But little Timmy can go and shoot up a whole school. Mm-hmm. But don't whip him. This is what's going on today.
Amen.
Love, I don't care. You can say whatever you want to say. The judge, anybody else can say whatever they want to say. But when God says discipline that child, raise them up right. When he tells us to spare not the rod or we'll spoil the child, that's the one we're supposed to be listening to. That's the one we're supposed to be doing right by. Because he knows even more than we even know. Guess what? Love brings correction. When Latrice go out there and do something wrong, I ain't going to sit up there and say, ha-ha, Jay, you're going to be all right. No, that was wrong. You did, Latrice. I need you to get it right. That's not pleasing unto God. Whatever you do, make sure it's pleasing unto God. My daughter sitting right back there, I tell her every day, whatever you do, seek God. Let God lead you. When she come and talk to me about certain things, if it's going to take you out of the will of God, no, baby, leave that alone. Mm-hmm. Because we got to train them up. And I love her enough. I love you enough, Sister Shamika, to say, look, baby, God has great things for you. Don't do that. Don't go that way. Mm-hmm. Don't go that route. I love you enough, because that's my job. Mm-hmm. That's my job. See, Deacon, even though you in life is my father, I still love you enough to say, Deacon, that's not the right thing to do. You might not want to try that right there, because I love you.
Amen.
See, love ain't going to sit up there and let you go on in your mess and cheer you on. No, I love bringing correction. Let's go back to the word, Lord God. Verse 3 saying, and though I bestow all my goods to feed the poor, and though I give my body to be burned and have not charity, it profits me nothing. Huh. You mean to tell me I go down there and spend all that time down there at the soup kitchen, sweating and going on, feeding them people. They look at them, they ain't trying to find no place to live. They lazy, I don't know what. But I'm still going there. Here go your mashed potatoes. Here, take your bread. Mm-hmm. down there every day, so I know God see me down there. But what's wrong with this picture? Mm-hmm. You down there, but are you down there in love? Mm-hmm. Are you down there representing Christ? See, when I go to that prayer center, glory to God, on Monday nights, I don't go there, Sister Shamika, to sit in there and see who praying what and who praying, who can say the best prayer. I go and I say, God, lead me. Lead me and guide me. See, your people are in need. They are hurting. And when they're hurting, God, give me what it is you want to say to them and let me speak it into their lives like you have already ordained. Because this is what we're here for. We're supposed to be here to help us one to another. When he tell us, glory to God, to treat our neighbor as we treat ourselves, that means, look, if I'm in need, I want somebody to assist me. If I need prayer, I want somebody to pray for me. Amen. I ain't made it in there yet. I still need prayer. I need pastor. I need everybody else to pray for me. Sister Shamika, I need your prayers. Sister Latrice, I need your prayers. Deacon, I need your prayers. I won't sit up here and say I don't need no prayer. Yes, I do. So when I go out there, I go in there wholeheartedly. Because I want to do it to the glory of God. I don't care about who don't like me. I don't care about who don't care about what I need or whatever. Later for all that, I have no time to worry about Felicia when I'm on a mission to do God's work. We on a mission, y'all. God is coming back sooner than we think. And the only thing you can do is make sure you got your house in order, glory to God, that when he come back to receive you, you'll be ready to go.
Amen.
If you don't make it in, it's nobody's fault but your own.
Right.
Nobody's fault. We walk around here and we talk about love. I love you, I love this, but you study yet hurting the person. I love you, but I can't tell you that shacking up is wrong. I love you, but I can't tell you that going out here, and even though you're not out on the corner prostituting your body, but you are there to go, oh, I'm going to do some strange things for a little bit of change. No, I love to tell you, no, that's wrong, baby. That's wrong. Because we have a provider. His name is Jesus. He will provide us with everything we need, Sister Shamika. I got to truly hand it to you. I ain't have no money all week long, glory to God. I went. And I got a card that I keep money on every now and then. And I went and I had me some money on that card. I said, Lord, you will provide.
Yes.
And I told him, thank you. I said, God, don't nobody love me like you love me.
Thank you, Jesus.
I asked somebody to come give me an estimate on fixing up some things in my house. God never called me back, never got in touch with me. I said, God, give me wisdom. Mm-hmm. I went in there and tried to fix my own bathroom yesterday. Flooded it out, but I did good. Flooded it out. Had to call the city, come out. Hey, y'all, come cut this water out. It's all over the place. Come on, it's getting out of my hallway. Then the man come in there. Guess what he did after he turned the water off social media? He come in. I said, come here, I got something for you to do. He come in. I said, I need you to get on there and tighten that bolt up under there. Can you do that? I'm like, well, we don't do that kind of work. I said, I ain't asking what kind of work you did. Just get on there and cut. I need strength to tighten that bolt up right there. Because guess what? When I'm in need, and if you can provide, provide. God don't care about what jobs we work.
Amen.
He don't care about what we got to do. God want us to be, when at that point in time, if God needs you to do something, he want us to do it. At that point in time, Sister Shamika, I didn't care about he worked for the city. I want him to tighten that boat up.
Amen.
I couldn't tighten it up, and you got all these muscles, and you standing up in there looking on my shirt. Man, get on there and tighten that boat up under there. Because it's time out now.
Amen.
I don't need you standing up on my shoulder if you ain't going to help. Go on about your business. He gonna tell me you got a mess in here to clean up and gonna walk out the door. I said, yeah, my call us if you need. I said, oh, I'll call you to cut that water back on since you ain't good for nothing else.
Amen.
I'm not gonna lie to you, Sister Shamika. I'm sorry. I'm just gonna point out blank tell you because it's a reason why God created all of us to be helpers one to another.
Yeah.
We can't be looking for excuses to get out of something. If somebody needs your help, give them your help, glory to God. I don't mind, Sister Shamika. If I'm on my way to work, glory to God, somebody need help. I don't mind stopping what I'm doing and helping them. I just gotta say, look, I'm gonna be late. I'll be there when I get there. Right now, I'm assisting in a situation. It's time for us to be about our Father's business.
Mm-hmm.
say you love me, you are a Christian, but you can't stand to be around me. You can't come visit me when I'm on my sick bed, or you can't come and bring me food because I'm hungry, or you can't help me with a bill and God already blessed you with the money. You can't even provide and help me with a bill. Come on. Church people, God tired of you. Because if you love God, you got love. Because Jesus Christ is love. Verse 4 says, charity suffers long. Going through. You're going to go through. See, people with a loving heart endure a whole lot of stuff. Amen. Endure a whole lot of pain. Because of that heart. Because of that love. People feel like they can treat you any kind of way. Walk all over you. Use you. Mistreat you. Abuse you. Throw you away. Say what they want to say to you. And you just have to sit there and take it. But guess what? Not so. Because I'm one of them that reads my word. And my word told me, Sister Shamika, he will fight my battle.
Yes, he will.
All I got to do is talk to him. Amen. And give it to him.
Yes.
Now tell me that ain't love.
Love.
I ain't got to lay a finger on you.
Love.
My Father will take care of you. He can do a better job with you than I can.
Amen.
He loves me.
Yes,
he tells us all the time, his words say, touch not my anointed, nor do my prophets any harm. You watch it when you put your mouth on God's people. You watch it when you're coming up against God's people. Because he don't like that. You ain't trying to do what is right. But that don't mean God gonna let you come in and disrespect his people, hurt his people, and do all whatever you want to do to them. Because he will not. He will not. You say love suffers long. It cut like a two-edged sword, says Shamika. It comes in, it gets that very hidden sin that we don't even want to admit. I don't want to admit that I'm a liar. I don't want to admit, glory to God, that I do steal. You taking a pen from work? Yeah, that's stealing.
Amen.
You sitting up there talking about, honey, it'll be all right. You just lied to that person, especially if they're living in sin. No sin is going to make nothing all right. If you can sit up there and lie to them and tell them that they're going to be all right and you know what they're doing is wrong, you know you're lying. And you're
Amen.
Stepping out of line.
Amen.
And you're wrong.
Praise the Lord. God is good. Thank you, Jesus.
And it's kind. Love is kind. Mm-hmm. So, Shamika, you're looking nice today.
Mm-hmm.
You're looking very nice. Love don't lie to us.
Amen.
Love lets us know the truth. Y'all some beautiful young ladies. Y'all got it going on for yourself, whether you know it or not.
Amen.
Deacon, you're a very handsome man. Love is kind. Love ain't gonna take it out, take you all the way out there and throw you out in the water and leave you out there. Love's Charity envy not. So you people that sitting there in church envying what your sister and your brother's got, you're wrong. Fall on your knees and repent. Charity vaunteth not itself. It is not puffed up. Do not behave itself unseemly. Seek not her own. Is not easily provoked. Thinketh no evil. This is the definition of love, y'all.
Amen.
This is what love is.
Amen.
If you're going to go out here and you're going to be on a mission to do God's work, guess what? You got to have a pure, clean heart. You ain't got time to be jealous of your sisters and your brothers.
You
ain't got time to be envious of what they got. You ain't got time, glory to God, to be puffed up and high-minded and thinking it's all about you, because it's not. It's not. Love is humble. Humility. Jesus showed us the way. I just quoted y'all that scripture. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. Verse 6 says, rejoice not in iniquities, but rejoices in the truth. Beareth all things, believeth all things, hope all things, endureth all things. Charity never faileth. But rather there be prophecy, they shall fail. Rather there be tongues, they shall cease. Rather there be knowledge, it shall vanish away. For we know in parts, and we prophesy in parts. But when that which is perfect is come, then that which is in part shall be done away with. When I was a child, listen to what Paul's saying, because we got a lot of childish people sitting up in these churches. When I was a child, I spoke as a child. I understood as a child. I thought as a child. But when I became a man, I put away childish things. For now we see through a glass darkly, but then face to face. Now I know in parts, but then shall I know even as I, even also I am known. And now abide faith, hope, charity. These three, but the greatest of these is charity. We talking about love. It endures everything.
Amen.
It endures all. It conquers all.
Yes, it does.
And guess what? If you think you don't know what love is, or if you think you do know what love is, and can't nobody tell you nothing, well, read in 1 Corinthians,
Amen.
The 13th chapter. It'll describe love to you.
Amen.
Jesus said, Peter, if you love me, you'll feed my sheep.
Yeah.
You'll tell them what's right. You won't stir them the wrong way. You won't tell them that I'm pleased with what they're doing when I'm not. We got a lot of stuff going on in these churches, and we need to start pulling some stuff down before God come in and tear it down.
Amen.
And he ain't far from tearing it down. We need love. If you don't have love in your heart, guess what? Don't leave the building today until you get it from God. Because Jesus Christ is love. He loves us enough, glory to God, to make sure that we have everything we need. He loves us enough. A lot of us by right don't even supposed to still be here. Supposed to be gone. And when I say gone, we supposed to be gone through the grave right about now. But it's because Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Because he loves us. It's because he cares so much for us
Amen.
That he, glory to God, because of his obedience, it gave us life.
Amen.
It gave us life. So it's time for us. When you going around out there, if you a Christian, you go out there, let them see Jesus in you. Let them feel that love. Let them know, look, that's a place I can go and get what I need. I can go over to Sister Latrice and be encouraged. I can go to Sister Shamika and get prayer. I can go to Brother Deacon Gilbert and he can intercede with me and we can work out some stuff pertaining to my child and everything else that's going on.
Amen.
See, this is what people need. I'm not patting you on your back because you feel like you done such a great job. No, ain't none of us done no great job. We all here striving to do the same thing, make it to heaven.
Amen.
And the only way we're going to make it to heaven is except we have that love in our heart.
Praise God. Thank you, Jesus.
Love conquers all.
Yes, it does. Thank you.
It don't, it's not puffed up. It don't abuse. It don't neglect. It don't talk down on you. It don't make you feel bad. Instead, it provides you with meekness, temperance, a cushion that you can love somebody else. See, it's hard for somebody, and I don't know why I'm saying this, but anyway, it's hard for somebody to love another person when you don't have love in your own heart.
Amen.
In order to give love, you gotta have love. And if
Amen.
You ain't got that love in your heart, guess what? You can't help nobody.
Amen.
It's an individual God been dealing with me about all week long, glory to God, saying, I need you to tell her. If she want that heart to survive, she need to fill it with love and get all this other stuff out of it. Because guess what? Without that love, nothing else works out for you.
Amen.
We need love. We need to show love. Ain't nothing wrong with embracing somebody. There's nothing wrong. The word of God said, greet your brother with a holy kiss. Ain't nothing wrong with greeting your brother and your sister with a holy kiss. Just don't go beyond that.
Amen.
Some people go beyond it, but don't go beyond that. God loves us. He wants us to do right. It's time for us to do what God tells us to do. It's time to get this love back in our hearts.
Mm-hmm.
Stop walking around here with the form of godliness and become a child of God, a true child of God. Later for that, put off that form. And put on that love. See, form tell me, I come to church dressed in my finest of finest. I ain't got time to be hugging nobody or giving a little cute little hug. No. But love says, let me hug her because she needs a hug. And give her a tight grip.
Amen.
It's going to be all right, baby. Regardless. Because see, the word of God even tells us. And if you got something on or you involved in something or got something that's going to stop you from giving God due praise, you better get rid of it.
Amen.
Leave it alone. Nothing Amen. Should stop us from giving God due praise. For he is truly good.
Yes, he is.
Let's pray for our sisters and our brothers.
Amen.
People nowadays, all they want to do, church people guilty of this too, all you want to do is gossip about somebody and what's going on in their life. Let's pray for our sisters and our brothers. Mm-hmm. It's praying time, y'all. God coming back. And guess who the first person he gonna come and see?
Amen.
The house. He coming straight to the house.
Amen.
And if he come to this house and find not the things of his in this house, guess what? That house right there, he will leave and that house will be cursed. So the best thing for us to do is to do it the way God tell us to do it. Fill these houses with love. Let's get back in our right places with God so God can do what he need to do through us. Because, y'all, we don't run nothing. I don't know why people feel like, oh, that's my church. Oh, that's mine. That's mine. That's mine. Got so much mind and stuff till your mind just really gone. You don't even mind the things that is important.
Amen.
And that's Jesus Christ.
Praise the Lord.
Let's put our minds back on him. Nothing down here belongs to us. We don't belong to ourselves. We belong to God.
That's right.
Let's give him what's due him. Later for all this other stuff.
Thank you, Lord.
This week, glory to God, encourage somebody.
Amen.
Help somebody. It's not hard. Just stop and encourage and help somebody. Just do it this week. See how it feel. Those of you that don't know how to love your neighbor, don't know how to treat your neighbor, just go and help somebody. Help two people this week. You can help them in any kind of way, whether it be in encouragement, whether it be you to bodily help them, whatever it is. Help two people.
Amen.
And see how I feel. And if that feel good to you when you do that, keep on doing it. Keep on doing it. Because this is what we're here for. That's how you get your blessing. See, our blessings ain't it. We come in here and sit around in this church all day long and talk about how good God is and give our testimony to one another. But our blessings ain't in here. It's out there. Go out there to Sister Shu out there who's out there on the street corner prostituting her body. Go up there and tell her Jesus love her. That's where your blessing at.
Amen.
We used to sing a song all the time. I need you, you need me. Well, guess what? We do. We need each other. They need us too. Let's go out here and help them. God is good, glory to God. Prayer says something to help somebody out today, glory to God, because we got to focus on